Got it again. How you doing today? I am playing the park. It's a creepy kind of horror interactive novel, I guess. We're going around. Continually delayed by the incompetence of the builders. The problem is that they are local, so they believe a lot of the rumors about what old man Henderson used to do here. They grew up on these tales. Every time a bolt comes loose or a wrench goes missing, these fools are crossing themselves against the black magic. Of course, that is why I chose the site over all the other potentials. Solomon Island is a nexus for dark energies, and the thought of all that power just dissipating beneath the earth here, it makes my skin crawl. I called in a few favors back in Brooklyn and got someone at the local academy to see if they had any interesting books about local history. Turns out they do, and it turns out that old man Henderson has some pretty strong connections to the Brooklyn crowd. Perhaps something he wrote will help me find the piece of the plans that I am missing. Builders. So there's something about black magic here. Something built on an ancient portal. I've still got a feeling that I'm reading into shit to justify or to find an excuse for my son being dead, because I just can't get over it. I can't accept it. So I need to find all these like weird conspiracies.
Doesn't surprise me.
Inspector comments, after touring the park, riding the rides, and viewing the startling number of incidents suffered here in the park, it is the inspector's opinion that Atlantic Island Park should be shut down until Nathaniel Winter complies with all safety regulations. While I understand that there is a sensitive political relationship between Mr. Winter and the Senator, I nevertheless suggest that such political considerations be set aside in condemning Atlantic Island Park. The rides at first glance appear well constructed and maintained, but the sheer number of incidents in the park during the last few years and during constructions lead me to believe that there is something wrong at the base level of construction, and we should close the park and fully investigate these flaws. To wit, here is a partial list of the fatalities in the park since opening only 2 years ago. Family of three killed when a roller coaster cart derailed. 14 separated incidents of broken bones and crushed ribs. 3 suicides from top of the Ferris wheel. Oh god, are some people going to jump off right now? A child seriously injured on the escalator. Over a dozen children reported missing in the House of Horror since... Oh, don't make me go in there. One report of drowning in the Tunnel of Tales. The sheer volume of incidents makes it the strongest recommendation that Atlantic Island Park be closed immediately. Oops. Who am I talking to? Who the fuck am I talking to? Decrease the speed. It's gonna be some kids at the top of here. Oh, I'm not gonna say that dude again, am I? If you saw the last video, there was like this giant, creepy, grinned figure. I keep calling them the Babadook. I don't know, man. He's in a top hat. Looks like some kind of Tim Burton's
people nightmare. Come into your life for a reason. Dad used to say that before Mom ran off. After that, he mostly just drank. Things were different for Don and I. When we met, I was sweeping the floor at Susie's diner. He came in with some workers, but he didn't try to flirt or cop a feel like the others. He just ordered a coffee and sat there, watching me. When my shift was over, he offered to walk me home. I don't know how to describe that walk. We talked and laughed and eventually kissed. It felt like love. It felt like a fairy tale. I can't tell you if Callum was made that night or one of the ones that followed, but I think it has to be that night. That one perfect night.
It'd be creepy if someone was just sitting opposite you.
Then, well,
after looking out the window.
He died.
Just sitting in that
seat.
According
to the supervisor, his safety harness failed when he was working on the top of the Ferris wheel. Don was there one moment, and then gone. Sometimes people leave your life for no reason. I was 3 months pregnant with Callum. Fairy tale fucking over.
Fairy tale fucking over. I've got a feeling they're going to do something with that seat. I'm scared to just look out the window. Come on, where is it? Where's the jump scare? Do not put someone in that seat. Gonna be someone standing there waiting for me! I knew it. He was in the booth. The Babadook. And he's gone now. He's trying to help me at least. Let me check out these fucking awesome rides. Go on, get you going again. So I think it's going to be a very passive story, and I'm probably not going to have to run and hide from him, I guess. But you never know how these games turn out. Imagine a truly scary horror game like... Okay, well, we haven't been this way because we're on the other side of the broken bridge. Truly scary horror game like if you just stop and look up when you look down, someone's standing there, like, and they just start to speak to you. Exactly you, they know you. I think it would be something like, you know, that Black Mirror episode where it's actually rooted in your brain. Can I go along here? What on earth? Can I jump? Okay, which is the right way to go? What did I do wrong? I definitely went the wrong way then. I think the rides are too spaced out. This would be a boring park. We'd just be walking constantly. So who's the dude in the top hat? Is that the owner? Is it Nathaniel Winter? Steve seems to be the chipmunk. It seemed to imply he turned into a bit of a killer. I could smell the corpses on his suit. Take the roller coaster ticket, please. Okay, that didn't work that well. Some kind of just the sound effects. I don't think you should need to use loud music to accentuate a horror note. I think if you just see something in the corner of your eye and then it's closer, but you don't do it with music, because that's just, it's cheap.
A lot of people idolize their children. You hear them talking about their kids and just the way they talk, their fucking voices make me want to vomit. My angel likes to read, and little Johnny is so good on the piano. Fuck those people!
Sounds like Bill Burr.
You give up 9 months of your life carrying them, you traumatize yourself giving birth to them, and then you spend the rest of your life as their slave. Wiping asses, mopping up piss, feeding them, little life-sucking monsters who take and take and take until...
Did you kill Callum?
We all go insane. Any parent who pretends otherwise is just dishonest. That's called choice supportive bias. I am honest. Callum really grinds my gears, and he owes me everything. Everything. It served the little fuck right if I just abandoned him.
Harsh but fair. Wear a rubber. Well, this is green for go.
I always wanted to ride this one. Never got around to do it before.
Well, perfect time, you know, being in the middle of the desolate park at night. I just know there's gonna be some kind of lame. There he is.
What do you want?
We need to talk about Caleb.
Is that Mark Hamill?
What have you done to him?
That's insulting. You and your boy are everything that this place doesn't want. The antithesis of what we stand
for. His right
for.
Hand is just like a hoop.
Where is Callum?
The poor child. He tried so hard to do what he was taught. He even left you a trail of breadcrumbs. But the park is just so hungry.
Tell me where my son is.
The witch has him now. Has both of you. No happy ending here, I'm afraid.
Just leave me alone.
Fool. You always were.
Just let me ride the roller coaster in peace. Whee! Callum. Oh shit. Nicely done. Oh, I like it because that's her feet. That's a nice touch. That was good. That made sense. Is the moon like a spotlight? That sounded too much like Mark Hamill to me. Oh, that looks stupid, man. Come on! Taste your dreams. I'm sorry, Callum! So, is the guy with the top hat a good guy or what? He seemed quite cordial in that conversation, like he was trying to help me. The witch has our son. Has us both. And the way she talked to him, like, what do you want? Like we've met before. So some black magic shit going on here. Oh no.
The witch awaits. Callum, where are you?
How do I use the flashlight? Guessing she's just gonna automatically use it when I need it.
Callum has bruises on his arms, finger marks. Someone has been hurting him. I've asked him, demanded really, to know where he got the marks. But he doesn't want to answer me.
It was Daddy O5.
Something has scared him into silence. Doesn't dare talk. He's been changing too. Something sinister lurks in the darkness behind his eyes. I catch him staring at me at odd moments. In the night, he tosses and turns and cries out words that I cannot understand.
Well, which way am I going?
When I try to soothe him, he snaps and bites at my fingers.
Oh, Jesus. Let's go this way.
I think he wants to talk to me. I think he wants to tell me. But they are watching him every minute of every day. They are whispering to him in his sleep, changing him. They are taking my baby away from me. I can save him. And there will be pain. But I love him, and in the end, you will understand why.
So I guess we came here. Oh, he's gonna be standing there when I read this.
The whole town was shocked by that one. Never found out who did it.
Cotton candy corpse leaves sour taste in popcorn's mouths. Yesterday evening, visitors to Atlantic Island Park were shocked and horrified by the discovery of a dismembered corpse behind the cotton candy stand, according to the local authorities. The corpse had yet to be identified, however, they have confirmed that the remains appear to be those of a child. The corpse was discovered by a group of teenagers from Innsmouth Academy. Now, Innsmouth is from Lovecraft lore. Who notices a pair of ravens tugging at something just out of sight behind the shack. Nathaniel Winder, the owner of Atlantic Island Park, has released the following statement. It is a true tragedy when something like this occurs, especially in a place that was designed to bring forth happiness and joy. The staff of Atlantic Island offer their condolences to the family and friends of the victim and will cooperate fully with authorities to help bring this case to rest. The Solomon Chronicle will provide daily updates on the story going forward. Well, that was probably the chipmunk. There's definitely Lovecraft all over this thing. Pickled punks. Things are about to get a little bit weird. Is the body still going to be there? I'm scared, man. I'm getting a little scared. This game, it knows what it's doing. These doors are all starting, are going to start to open, aren't they? There's fucking footsteps, man! I'm not moving. I'm scared.
Poor bastard. Who did this to him?
He said it was, he's dismembered.
This isn't a game, Callum!
Callum! They said the corpse was dismembered! You fucking assholes. That wasn't that bad, because he just... I don't like it when they just evaporate like that. Let's get the mic close. Yeah, let's take some pills.
These are mine.
Night and eighties. Don't believe anything they tell you. Cool, okay. Here's a... Oh, jeez. That's less impressive now. Things are starting to get a little stupid.
Don't touch me!
I don't like it because I just can't even... I can't focus. It's hurt my eyes. Oh dear.
Oh God, no. Park is a collage of contradictions all of its own. Millions of people die every year in car crashes, and the park has little cars designed specifically to simulate that action. Hear the children scream with joy. In the sideshow alley, you can walk away with 15 cents worth of mass-produced Chinese teddy bears while a grinning carny pockets your hard-earned $5. What secrets lie beneath the sullen waters of the lake? The tears of jilted lovers, the soiled condoms of illicit affairs, the clotted blood of the lonely suicide. And the face of the witch looms over it all. I've always despised her toothy grin and warty nose. I hate that sparkle in her weathered, watchful eyes. I think Callum is waiting for me. Inside.
Great. Fucking great. Get your flashlight on. Whoa, a loading screen. Okay, so is that like the first level, or is this like the last part? I don't know. Oh, Jesus! Yeah, I'm not feeling this at all. Fuck me. Atlantic Island Park has closed its gates. A jeering throng of townfolk gathered as we hung the heavy iron padlock on the gates. Small-minded fools, scared of what they don't understand. My machines lie silent and dejected, but I am not beaten. Oh, sorry. I have sent my wife and son back to Boston, and I've retreated here to the House of Horrors. I must think. Okay. I must think about what? Well, that's calm. Fuck me. Yeah, I'm gonna shoot myself. I think, how do you kill a witch? I don't think you can. My lord. Just give me back my son! Leave me alone. Oh, that was stupid. That was kind of stupid. I think these designs run kind of counter to the theme. They look kind of DeviantArt-esque. Oh, there he is. I think he's trying to help me in a weird way. A shadow with no body. He's got one hand, and his right hand looks like a kind of tail. So if something grabs me. Oh, fuck. Of course it turned around. They always do that. I'm not nervous. I'm not nervous. I'm freaking the fuck out, man! Jesus! Oh, God, why? Why a table? Why just a single chair? This is pretty effective horror. I am feeling chilly right now. Like nervous to move. And it's because you get nervous of the jump scares. They do prey upon your disposition somewhat. I'm not sure if I'm meant to look for anything or if I'm meant just to go, well, you know, A to B. I don't think this game has much. I can't remember. Look, we get it! You're turning around! It's clever! It's a nice trick! Watch this. You watching it? Well, you didn't do it that time. Okay, where the fuck am I meant to go? Nothing in there. Okay, I gotta go this way. Nice. You got a light! That didn't get me. Too slow. The creepiest thing was just footsteps. Like, I stopped walking. Oh, okay. I stopped walking and then footsteps were just continuing. That's more scary to me than just these big, you know, animals popping up. It's, is that the Walking Dead? Come on, man. Stop overplaying your hand. Convenient. I don't know if he's helping me. Can we open that door? Oh god. Don't go downstairs. Do not go downstairs! Now this thing we can rotate. Nightmare Circus. A circus burnt to the ground on an opening night, killing dozens. The owner is put to death by an enraged mob of townsfolk. Just as he shouts out a curse, now raven. A dark-souled wanderer comes to the ruins at dusk in search of his missing mother.
After they let me out, they gave me Callum back and sent me home with a handful of breadcrumbs. Home bit a sweet home.
So this is my house.
I barely recognized it. Where there had been color and light, more shadows and regrets. Where there had been warmth, there was a bone-deep coldness that never went away. I tried my hardest to keep the ghosts at bay. Don, watching from the dusty corners while I tried to teach his son to read. My father, coldly assessing me and finding me lacking. I devoted myself to Callum, did the things that they told me. It will get better, they said. Every day will be a little better than the last. I'm in the woods now, lost and afraid. Things never got any better.
So did the park just burn down and I'm like a ghost? After multiple attempts to collect payment, we regret to inform you that your services has been disconnected and will be disconnected shortly. Please do the following. Make the payment listed on the last bill. Contact us and we can arrange a payment plan that you can immediately be connected. If you believe that this is an error, call us. If you are unable to make payment, please contact your local welfare office to discuss a placement for you and your loved ones. Winter in Maine is cold and brutal. Don't face it without electricity. Dunwich. That's another. Pretty sure the Dunwich Horror is something else from Lovecraft. True story of the Donnas. On April 16th, a group of covered wagons began the 2,500-mile journey to California. Just 8 months later, they found themselves stranded in the Sierra Nevada mountains with very little to bite or sup. It was become one of the greatest tragedies of westward migration that the world had ever seen. Now our panel of Donna experts have uncovered compelling evidence that the families were forced to resort to cannibalism in order to survive that terrible winter. It was never before seen. Exposé read about how the Donna children were forced to eat their own brothers and sisters in order to survive. All here in the pages of this shocking true story. I've got a feeling the cover is going to be different because it was gingerbread men. Yeah. So they're relating it back to the Hansel and Gretel story. Bite or sup seems to be coming up a lot. The wilting. A solar flare has struck the earth. That's knowing. Millions of people are unproofed from their homes, uprooted from their homes. A young meteorologist searches desperately for a way to stop global overheating. And an exotic dancer named Chance O'Hara is the key to saving the world again. Okay. It's a piss take on Independence Day and knowing. The wilting. Interesting. Oh, it's a wrench. Can I take it? I took the kid's shoe. I'm not that peckish. I've got a feeling we were there the opening day and it burned down. We're just a ghost haunting the grounds. Miss Maylard, as we agreed in our meeting today, we consider you fully recovered from your illness. This letter is official notification that you are considered sound of mind and body and may return to work at any time. Please note that you should discontinue any medication that you have been using and dispose of any remaining medicines. If you feel any time you are suffering a relapse, then please contact your local physician immediately. We wish you continued good health. Oh, I'm so tired. Barely slept a wig last night. Alright. Fuck me. Lorraine, I received your letter and I'm quite surprised. You ran off with your father all those years ago. And then disappeared off the edge of the map, and then when I finally tracked you down, refused to answer any of my letters. And now you write to me asking for help. I have another family now and another life. Your father was a horrible man, and I regret the years that I wasted with him. I loved you. I truly did. But every year you grew more and more like him. You were his girl, never really mine. Still, I would have fought for custody if you hadn't ran away with him. It broke my heart, but I needed to go on living. I can't let you back into my life without picking open old wounds. I'm sorry, Lorraine, but I just can't do it. Maybe one day it will be easier and I can meet Callum, but not yet. I am not ready to forgive you. Please don't contact me again. So that's my mother, I guess. Didn't want to be around my dad. She's willing to meet my son. Lorraine seems to be suffering from depression that began early in her pregnancy. Our discussions have made it obvious that these episodes stem from grief of losing her partner, Don, who died about 6 months ago. There are several unresolved issues with her father. After being kept under careful observation, we provided standard treatment for this disorder, including electroconvulsion therapy. The patient responded and made a rapid recovery. Lorraine has a newborn who was placed in foster care shortly after birth. When Lorraine displayed symptoms of disorientation and depression, it is our judgment that Lorraine is fit to have her son returned to her, as long as she follows a recommended aftercare routine and continues with her medication. We have faith that she will make an effective caregiver. Lorraine has her own housing, and her employee Susie has said that she is welcome to return to her shifts at the diner. Norma Creed, a local woman, has offered to care for Callum while Lorraine works. It is with this support network in mind that we feel confident releasing Lorraine from this institution. Prescription of Zoloft. Okay, 1977. So is she like just crazy? Is that what happened? Son was taking the care of others and she went crazy missing him. And she's made up this whole theme park scenario. Guys, I'm gonna have to leave it there. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, comment, and subscribe. Oh my god, there's so many notices. Miss Maylard, our inquiry into the estate of Mr. Donald Williams has been completed. We regret to inform you that the primary beneficiaries of his estate, including the life insurance settlement for accidental death, were listed as Rose Williams and Richard Williams of New York State. The deceased parents, our agency made contact with Mr. and Mrs. Williams and explained your situation, especially as regards to the birth of Donald's sons, Callum. Unfortunately, they were not receptive to our overtures, and they specified that without any legal proof of a biological relationship, they consider you ineligible to receive any of the monies from Donald's estate. So they were just cunts. They have asked that we no longer contact them regarding this matter. I understand that this may have a negative impact on your current financial situation, and I hope that I'm not being too forward when I enclose the bill for our services with this letter. Sincerely, Edward Stapleton. So she's basically been getting shit on constantly. Guys, I'm going to leave it there. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, comment, and subscribe. And catch me next time for some more The Park. Goodbye, guys.